Hello everyone and welcome to my talk at DEF CON 29. So in this talk we are going to see the bug hunters recon methodology. So before starting, let me introduce myself. So my name is Tushar Verma and I am working as an application security engineer. I am also a part of Cinec Red team and a full-time bug bounty hunter. I am also an InfoSec trainer and speaker. So let's see the agenda for this talk. So the first thing which we'll be seeing will be the scope review for any bug bounty program. Then we'll be moving forward to before recon and after recon, like when we are starting, then what kind of information we will be getting from the company which we are testing. And then after recon, what kind of information we will be getting. Then we will be moving forward to scope-based recon methodology, and we'll be seeing the plus point, the benefit of that methodology. Then we'll be seeing the basic methodology. In this basic methodology, basically my aim is to just give you an insight, like, okay, if we are doing recon, and the main thing which is like you need to use every single information which you are getting from it and use it to make your like recon more and more useful, so that you can like get more like endpoints, more like information, so that you can get new vulnerability and then you can get paid for it. And after that, at last, we'll be seeing the tools and automation frameworks, basically, because nowadays, you know, we can automate each and everything. So we'll be seeing like how we can like automate these things. And there are many automation frameworks also available in open source. We can use that also. So the first thing is scope review for in program. So before recon also, you need to first do some scope review for the program which you want to start with. So this is a very like not so easy task for everyone. So you need to first see the assets. So what is the assets? So the inscope and the outscope items present for any program. So basically, if you got more inscope items on your like program, then of course you can start with it, because you have more things to test. You have more endpoints, more like you can say more inscope items. So you can start with that. So if the asset is not that good, not that huge, so you can't like you know that in bug bounty program everyone is like testing on the same program. You have lots of competition. So for that you need to be like getting a assets. Like if you have more number of assets, the in scope items are more, then you can go with that program. The second thing which you need to say is the number of reports resolved. So of course, if anyone is reporting to any bug bounty program and the report number of report is always more, means the company is also very active and it is like they are taking action against every report they are getting. And they are patching everything. So of course the company is active. So the chances like you will be getting a reply from that company is more. So you can go for that company, like that program also. The third thing, and I think this is the most important thing, is the payout, because I think in bug bounty everyone is just like hunting for bounty only, like they just want reward money, huge like they are getting everything in bug bounty. So this is a very important thing. You need to see the payout, like okay, for like a particular kind of vulnerability, how much they are paying compared with 2-3 programs, and the program which you see, okay, this is the best payout in all these 3-4 programs, then you can go for it. See, it's a personal choice. It depends upon you. Now, the time to try, then time to bounty. This is a very important thing. Like, okay, after your bug has been accepted, you need to see, like, after how many like days you will be getting bounty, how many days it will take to just pay you and all. So you need to see these four things. Then only you can just see, like come to a like you can say we can just make up a mind, like okay, this program is best for me. Okay, you can say that. So you can start forward and start doing recon on that program. So now for recon, so when I just like, for example, I was like, let's suppose in Buckler or in Hacker One, we have everything given, like okay, the about the company assets, the number of report resolved, the payout, and the time to try and time to bounty. In Buckroad, we have only like, okay, after these many days, they will be giving you a response. Okay, So they give everything like clearly it mention everywhere. So you cannot select from these two. No, after that, when you will be like jumping into that program, you will see some basic information which is available on for every program. The first thing is company name, of course. Let's suppose in this case the company name XYZ, and you will be having the available scope also. So like all the in scope items, out of scope. This thing will be given. They will be also giving you some overview of the company business. And the fourth thing will be like they will give you some out of scope vulnerability, like they don't want these bugs to be reported. And they will also give you some focus area, like okay, focus on these bugs, these endpoints, because they want that endpoint or that point to be tested on their application. So these are things which is given to you before recon, like you're getting before recon only. Now, after doing recon, what the things which we are getting? So after recon, we are getting the first thing is the service info. The second is the backend technology use. The third is the interesting endpoints. The fourth is the juicy links which may be vulnerable. And then we are getting more and more things like after you're doing recon, of course you're getting more and more. So these are things like before recon and after recon you're getting. So now the main thing is like how to start doing recon. So the scope-based recon methodology by Harsh Bothra is best one. Why? Because first thing is like it will be saving you a lot of time because you know like okay for that particular scope you need to test that things only like a limited number of things only. You won't be like mixing up everything. Okay, the first thing. The second advantage is like the chances for getting duplicate or out of scope bug will be very less because you know about your scope, right? So if you know about your scope, then of course it's very good thing, and the chances of getting a bug which is not like accepted by company will be very less. So it's very good thing. Also, you can automate your recon workflow because you know about like okay, the scope is like small or medium or large. So of course you can automate that workflow also. And then you can just get all the information in just one automation, and it will also like you know basically the thing is like just blindly doing recon is not a very like not give you anything. Okay, so you need to understand the workflow first. So for that scope-based recon is the best thing. So scope-based recon basically we have three type of scope available: the small scope, the medium scope, and the large scope. So in the small scope, if we are getting, then we only get a single URL like the domain or the subdomain. Okay, so if we get any like for example evil.com or info.evil.com, then of course it's a small scope target. We'll be like moving forward the small scope recon. But the second one is the medium scope target. So in that we'll be getting a wildcard domain. That is *evil.com. This is like you can just see and okay, the wildcard domain present. Then of course you can go for the medium scope recon. Then comes the large scope one. So anything like if you are testing on a company, so anything about the company which is related to that company, we will be in scope. So you can do a large scope recon on that company. Okay. Now comes the basic methodology. So like why just for example if we are starting the recon phase, okay, and we need to like we are getting a target, let's say evil.com, it's a just like a medium scope one. So we need to start a recon here. Now the main thing is what happens in recon basically we just go on blindly doing recon and we don't use every single information which we are getting from it. So I will be giving you a basic like a workflow like what we can follow, and then you can automate also with some tools. So for example if we get our target, let's say evil.com, it's a wildcard domain, so we can first start doing the like we can run a sub finder MRs and we can get all the subdomains. We can save it in a folder, let's say any name we can give it. Now we have got all the like after getting everything from that, then we can just move it to the HTTPX or HTTP Pro, and we can filter out the active endpoint from them. Now, after getting the active one, we will be making one more folder for it. Now we got two. Now let's suppose that we need to get more and more information from these two only. So we'll be carrying on with the active txt file, and we will be like moving making it a scan from the, like, we need to get some more endpoints, some urls from it. So we'll be using wayback url and gov, and we can get all the like endpoints, which can be like, we can just go on for testing also, and any endpoint which is related to that particular domain we'll be getting from that. So now we got three files saved. Now after that, we can, now we got the first file which is having only subdomain. So now what we can do, we can just use the FUF tool, and we can just like get some more endpoint, we can brute force them, and if we are getting any like response for like 4xx, we can try to bypass that. So now after that, we'll be getting one more file, we can just save that file also. Now we got four files, just keep in mind that. Now after that, we can do a nmap scan on the active txt file, and in that, and like after doing that, we'll be seeing all the open ports and everything available. So we can now save it as let's say we can save it one new file now again. So we got around like the first file which is having only the subdomain, the second file is having only the active subdomain, the third file is having the data which we got after using FUF, like we are then the fourth one will be like having all the endpoints which we got from gov and wayback url, and the fifth one will be we are getting all the open port from nmap. Now the main task is to get some endpoint which we can start testing for this SQL or let's say XSS or any other vulnerability. So for that, we can use GF or GF pattern, and then we can start like for example, if you want to test for XSS, we can just use GF pattern and get all the endpoint which can be vulnerable to this particular bug. Okay, like or XSS or SQLi or LFI or anything else. So we'll be getting that. We can save it in a file. Now if we want to grab some JS file also, we can do that also from that. So these are something. Now after collecting every file, now we can just use an automatic scanner also, and we can pass all these file, and we can get a like some vulnerability from them also. Like we can just get some more endpoint, we can get some vulnerability, we can get some more information about target also. So this is a flow, like we are using every single information which we are getting from Recon, we're not wasting it. Okay, so now this is a very long workflow. Like of course I am not telling also, now I am sometimes I'm mixing many things, so it's a very long like process, and it will take time doing manually. So you need to like automate everything. So nowadays in open source, we are like we have got various like tools and frameworks which are available. So the best one, like which I am also using, the first one is the Recon FTW. Recon FTW is like it has everything like automated, everything, like every single thing which you want to do in Recon is like present in this tool, and it's a free open source tool, so you can use this to automate your Recon workflow. The second one is the Project Bheem by Harsh Bothra, and this is a like it is working on the method of scope-based Recon. So if you are following the scope-based Recon methodology, then you can use this tool. The third one is the Osmedius. It's an old one, but now also if you are if you want to just do a Recon scan and all, then you can use this tool because it is also giving you a proper result of that. Of course, it is a like, because these three tools are doing a lot of Recon work, so it will take time, of course. So if you don't have like a high end internet connection, then it will be very, it will take time. And of course, like because the tools are doing many various things, so you can do one thing, you can just use this tool in background and do things manually also. So manual plus automation, if you're doing in Recon, then of course it will be very it will be giving you an advantage also. And the main thing is, because you know like what you're doing, because if you don't understand the workflow about these tools and all, then of course it is very like hard for anyone to, because you're just you're like, for example, you're getting every information, but you don't know how to use that information further on for your testing, then it's a waste of time for you. And like you're running a tool, you're getting many various information, but you don't know how to use that. So of course it's a waste of time. So don't do that. Always first understand what you want to do, what you want from the target, what kind of information you need, and then only start your record. That's all. I hope you like enjoyed and my talk. If you have any query, then you can just contact me on my these handles. Thank you.